fuck the room, son, they fuck them on, they act like I never met a guy. A chip on my shoulder, about the size of a boulder. The roar is back on the block, drought season is over. You playing the house of Diddy, but I know she's a goer. This money, I'm about it like a no-limit soldier. Back on my mission, how the fuck it get right back in position? Championshipping that bullshit, Jordan and Pippen. Pay, I was slipping, now watch me reestablish the gripping. And in your West End, and the East, that day the fuck out the kitchen, that boy, I. Constantly mocking me, but they making the mockery. How they jocking me sloppily. Ain't no topping me simply. You can tell by my energy. I am not like you gimmicky niggas up in this industry. When the beat drop, start popping that shit bumping. When I'm rocking that party, I bet you that bitch jumping. Bet I ain't never been a nigga. Niggas was jumping. Always into something like them niggas straight out of Compton. Certified busser. I don't love her cause I don't trust her. And plus, I've been on the phone. Better bitches than Usher. Hate them or love. And if they hatin', then fuck them. Homie couldn't follow the leader long enough, so I drug them. See you north to the gorge, only yet on the map. All my niggas in Atlanta, where the fuck is she at? I be killing them out in Cali and Philly, real rap. Cross over in Minnesota, even wake up in Nap. That boy, I
know I'm at. Just what it is, what I need. I'm burning up the track. Oh, I know I'm burning up the track. Oh, I'm burning up the track.
Go, Jack.
Yo, yo, welcome back. I know you can't see me now, but now you can. Now
that's
you
a
can.
Good thing.
There you go again,
man. Nobody trying to see your face.
You always hate numbers.
Don't say more, I love you. Blues no more. Say more better.
Welcome back to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. It's another Friday. Once again, we do this every Friday, all the time, every time, at 8 Pacific Standard Time. This is when we lay it down. We lay it down every day, all day. I want to thank you guys. I don't know what's going on over there.
Hello.
Yeah, we're live and whatever. So look, I want to welcome back some heavy hitters back to the table as well.
I like that song that you play in the background, Shaka. I really like that song in the background.
You okay? You need some water?
I've been choked up. Y'all have to excuse me.
Oh my God.
I'm okay. I'm just a little choked up.
He's just a little choked up. Jeez.
But I know, seriously.
Asthma pump?
Billy Bob Thornton voice having mom.
You lucky there's a child in here. I would be going off on y'all right now. That's what's about to throw me off a little
you
bit.
You lucky it's a child up in here.
Right. No.
Steve, leave the room.
Welcome back, guys, to the Shock Factor. Leonard, I want to thank you
absolutely
once again. And my man, you know, and the professor. I cannot call you professor.
They need help.
I like that.
If you like that, that's cool.
Professor.
Professor Griff? No.
Professor.
No, well, you know Professor Griff.
Professor
Stain. Dropping some
Professor Stain.
He be dropping some stuff. On the stuff. Well, welcome back, everybody. So we got these two gentlemen here today.
On the correlation night.
And so I'm going to say, wow. Okay, I'm going
to let other words?
I'm going to let it go. Because look, at the end of the day,
express yourself, boy.
You know, we have some stuff to talk about. We talking about then, you know, the entertainment industry when you got in and where it is now.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to hear y'all reflections on that. You know, in reference to, you know, has it, you know, is it easier now, or is it, are you more, you know, because you're more wiser, you know, is it, you know, just more strategic? you know, in your approach.
Well, you gotta look at it as well, because the social media aspect of it is in play now. You know, all this new technology is in play.
Yeah, I wanna.
Well, here you go. There's a couple of different factors involved.
Want to get it from that guy first?
No, I was expounding off of what you said because of the position.
There's a couple of different factors.
I wasn't answering that. I wasn't answering that.
I just want to get it from him. Okay.
No, he's trying to get me back.
Don't let him mess with you.
He's trying to get me back. I wasn't answering the question. I was like expounding on that question.
A couple different factors are that when I first got in the business, I was young. And this whole business is about the youth. You know what I'm saying? And that's their whole market, the youth. Yeah. So once you cross 35, 40, you in trouble if you ain't got your own thing going. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because the numbers go down.
Right.
You know? And so instead of their top 10, now they're top 3. And there's quotas and there's numbers that you don't know about, but there's only two or three people you see working all the time. Mm-hmm. Right. There's a reason. Exactly. It's their favors and that's low risk.
Right.
They said they've already made money and they can continue to make money, and we're not going to take a chance on anybody else until they die.
It's guaranteed.
Wow.
You know, so you have that factor. Then on the flip side, 2013, everybody and their mama got a cell phone. That means everybody and their mama can make a movie.
Exactly.
That's what made me say about the social
media.
So
that makes it even crazier out. Because now you got a whole bunch of junk in your content, and you got to weed through all the trash and the junk and the wannabes to find the jewels the diamonds and the pearls, because you got everybody and their mama.
The collage.
Right.
Yeah, that's trying to get them, trying saturated. To get some because they think it's easy, mm-hmm. they think it's simple, and they think it's a quick step. 1, 2, 3. I'm famous.
Well, when you got YouTube,
everybody want 15 minutes.
Exactly. Everybody wants to be famous now.
So you got a lot of that going on.
Insta fame.
Yeah, I would say in just looking at music, you know, let's say back in the day, whatever that day was, you know, there might have been 30,000 or 40,000 singles released by the universe of people in the United States, and but in the music industry, 5 or 6 distribution companies controlled 80% of all the distribution, and each of them may have had 10 or 15 or 20 record companies, and 12% of the multi-billion-dollar music industry, of the artists that release records, they basically barely recouped the dollars that was given to them, and some of them continued. 3% of the industry musicians carried the whole industry. So to Leonard's point, the proliferation of media now and music, people can make their own music. They can make their own film. They can make their own music. So in one sense, it's tougher because you do have to cut through the clutter. But on the other hand, it's more open source. Mm-hmm. Everybody has the opportunity, because before, the A&R director was making the decision.
Right.
And I'm not going to hurt anybody's feelings out there, but no, they didn't even know, maybe. It was a hunch. There were some really good ones and some.
And they didn't know.
And another thing is, very few people could make a signing decision in a record company. Mm-hmm. Anybody walking around with cards saying they work for somebody, you know, and very few people want to take the risk, because if you take the risk, if you take too much risk and lose too much money, then you're out the door, and it's a revolving door. Fast forward to today, it's tougher. Leonard says it's more clutter. You have to fight through it, but the public decides.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, if you get a million hits on
popular
YouTube,
right.
That's YouTube, then all of a sudden it's an easy decision for somebody to sign you. They don't have to experiment and hope the public likes you.
So, is it more like, and speaking to both of you guys, is it really now about talent more than shock value?
No.
Not at all.
No, I'm going to tell you why. Because shock value, I said 15 minutes. I didn't say 2 years. And half of them just want 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So the shock value is going to get you noticed. You know? Then you have to worry about sustaining it once you get in. Mm-hmm. But once you just want to get noticed.
So when things go, what they call viral.
Right.
Right? You know, when these things go viral, millions and millions and millions of people, they know YouTube pay them XYZ money for those hits that goes on there, and they may end up getting, you know, tens of thousands of dollars, if not whatever, as well as the notoriety as well.
But then it becomes this. Okay, now let's see if you got any talent. Mm-hmm. You got numbers. But so, now let's see if you got some talent.
YouTube is selling advertising, so they're making money on advertising. You could be on YouTube and that may not make a penny.
Right.
Right.
Okay, so it's up to you to monetize or commercialize your content, if it's music or it's film,
right,
but and if figure out a way to distribute it in a way that you can make money. And if you once you are making money, then you're going to attract money and corporations.
If you got 3 million hits, YouTube is going to call you.
Exactly.
If you got 3 million hits, YouTube will contact
exactly.
you.
Yeah, they will. Right.
Because they want to tap into
what you got. Going.
What you got.
Right.
So they will tap into that if you got 3 million hits.
Mm-hmm. You know, but my I think one of my questions is like, do you really need? Right, granted, because you see some of the, like in music, some music I would never listen to.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, in the last maybe 5 to 7 years, maybe 10, right? Or, you know, in with the insurgence of rap music
mm-hmm.
and what's going on with that. Some of that I would never listen to.
Right.
Right. You know, mm-hmm. it's that talent, but they're making a lot of money, that's some right. of them.
But
you,
the music, you know, where, it was where controlled.
Where's the line?
Music was controlled because. The music company, the record companies wanted a certain kind of content, and they put music in certain categories of music,
mm-hmm.
and they aligned themselves basically with radio stations mm-hmm. who format fit each of those kinds of music. And so the music, so a lot of the creativity was driven by how it could be promoted,
mm-hmm.
which was primarily through radio. But, you know, when you talked about rap and how rap really, you know, was being sold, you know.
So, you know, because it's
not through the traditional channels.
Right.
And that's what's happening now. But it's very difficult. If you talk to music artists today or filmmakers today who are up and coming, they're very creative. But it's not always about the creativity because you have to, you may have an audience, but you have to find that audience. And then you have to figure out a way to turn whatever appeal that you have in the short span of time that you have appeal.
You know, it's monetizing.
You got to monetize it and turn it into money.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And yesterday's hit and two million hits might be 20 hits on YouTube.
Here's another example.
Exactly. In a month.
In a month.
Back in the day, you had East Coast sound.
There you go.
You had the Midwest sound. Mm-hmm. You had the West Coast sound. You didn't have a Dirty South sound back in the day, but now you do.
Man, you know what I'm saying? Sound,
and you had that like that because they was controlling how far that music went.
Right.
It didn't cross boundaries. You know what I'm saying? People still don't know what go-go is on the West Coast.
Right. No.
You know what I'm saying? You hear it in a song, but you don't know it unless you're familiar with it.
Right.
But now that, you know, everything is wide open, music is just crossing over.
It's
you
wide
know,
open.
So it's no more for regional sure. music.
Sure. You got people from Alaska that you're hearing rapping now.
So you got the Dirty South. And if you don't even know they're from the Dirty South unless they say they're from the Dirty South. Mm-hmm. But it's just that whole, mm-hmm. it's wide open.
Right.
It's
wide open.
You build an audience around this show in the time you've been here. You play, no one tells you what music to play.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
You've broken hits on this show, I know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, you know, I look
what's
at
what's the
it,
next one?
You know, ironically, you know, when I look at my publishing, you know, my thing statements and stuff, I see the work that happens here at the same time because I've been playing my shit.
Absolutely.
Do it.
Of course he does.
You should.
Hello.
Now, is it good?
Well, you want to hear something? You want to ask your mic?
I'm just playing.
I'm the shit. No, but
can I just say one thing? Can I say one thing? This is very important. Hard work, studying, and being prepared will always pay off in the end.
All your craft.
Yeah.
Always.
All yes.
You know, this is not an overnight thing.
Not at all.
You know, so if you're trying
again.
To do this for real, you got to put the work in.
Right.
You got to put the time in. You got to. You got to know what the hell you're doing.
Because, mm-hmm. but you know what? We're living in a society now where, you know, they're so thirsty and just, you know, they're hungry for this new, what's new, what's new, what's new, what's new. So that's why all these sensations and, you know, things going viral, you know, become so famous, whatever, because everybody, they just look for new to newness.
But there's this thing called integrity. It's this thing
exactly.
called the work.
The work.
You know,
that's
because in the film industry, a lot of it is initially a look.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but once you get past that look, you got to have something to back that up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Something's got to back that up.
Where's your skills?
You got to have some skills. And you can't get no skills by just watching TV.
You ask one of them, like, give me a monologue. They'll say, huh?
Right.
What are you talking about?
Right. Go to school. Get a craft.
Yeah. Yeah.
Get
a job.
Exactly.
You know, and everything, you know, with you know, being that everything is changing. You know, we're gonna wrap this thing up.
Sound like he was about to break into a song, didn't it?
I know, right? I thought he was
mad.
I was waiting.
I'm about to wrap it up, you know.
That's the shot.
No, but, you know, it's so much I want to talk. I want you first and foremost, I want to thank Ecor for, you know, bringing our guests, you know, inviting our guests in tonight. But I want you guys to feel free to come back here anytime you have something to say.
You didn't ask me about my wish.
You know, I was going to get to
that.
I'm not done yet.
You know,
yeah.
He's
we're not
closing
done.
Out.
I'm not. No, no, no.
Really?
That's because you killed Malcolm X.
Oh,
in the movie. In the movie.
In the movie.
In the movie.
In the movie.
But no, I was going
to Denzel.
I was going to get to your
You race. Signing off. You telling people goodbye.
No, I'm not.
Sayonara and shit.
No, I'm not.
Adios.
No, I wouldn't do that. Because there's so much I want to talk about. Our time is so short, right? And I just try to let it be freelance flow to that degree so I can try to get as much as I can, you know, from you guys. But there's so much more I want to get. You know what I'm saying? You guys have so much more to offer. We didn't go into some of the things that I really, really, really wanted to get to. Maybe we can get you guys back. But I just wanted to thank you first and foremost. Let you know, we really appreciate this here on the Shock Factor and on LA Talk Live. You know what I'm saying? We really, really appreciate you and thank
Truly
you so much.
And thank you, Shock Factor.
Absolutely.
Thank
you. You know, before I just wanted to get that out the way.
I'm shocked.
Okay, now about your wish.
Now about your wish.
Well, first of all, somebody just texted my boy and said, I said more opposed to Mo.
it is Mo.
It is Mo, but, you know, it's called articulation.
Ah!
And it's called enunciation.
B-Rock, you listening?
And,
B-Rock.
You know, it's just how we speak. Sorry. My wish. This is my wish. And I thought about this, too. My wish is I wish I can go back to ninth grade. No, I'll tell you why. Because... And know what I know now and go back. I'll be incredible.
What would you do? Man. What was one? What would be one thing that you would do?
Get the
Read
money.
More. Read more.
No, he would get the money for that dog that's over in Japan.
Right.
I wouldn't have did it. You
can
think of.
Man.
Hey, let me jump in here and just say this too on that point.
Uh-huh.
Because you often think when you reach a certain point in your life, wow, I wish mm-hmm. I knew then
what
I
know now.
Yeah, but
exactly.
The challenge is, though, that, yeah, it is, and we all want to go back,
mm-hmm.
but we are who we are because of everything
because
we've been
that.
Through to
exactly.
get here.
Yeah, but it's a damn wish.
Yeah, it's a wish.
right.
It's a wish.
But you know what? I say this a lot of the times. You know,
he said that ninth grade, okay.
Because I have the
ninth
same,
grade.
I have the, like, I wish I can go back and, you know, some of the football things, basketball things,
man.
Track things.
No, you can leave that back.
But, okay, Mo.
Back
okay.
then.
But one of the things.
You wasn't doing nothing then.
Oh, if
you go
ball.
Back now, you can do nothing.
Okay,
on the bench.
Cut her off.
Ride the bench. Yeah.
Because I know what you're saying, Mike.
But no, look, whatever, Mo. You know, we know what you was doing in the ninth, eighth grade.
That's right. I was going to church, praising Bubba Jesus. Gum. Show us.
We know that's a lie. But anyway, but all I'm saying is that what I had to come to the realization is if you're thinking like that, wishing you can go back, would not realize in the present that you're in that moment right now. Right. And realize that being conscious that you're in that moment right now, you can grab the future and live in the present right now.
Exactly. You can.
Did you write
yeah,
this shit
but
down
you know
somewhere?
What I'm saying? Anyway.
No, you know, I feel that.
I had to, consciously, you know.
No, but just like you said, when you thought about going back, you thought about your sports. You thought about what the things you could do differently or better yourself. Instead of cutting class, you might have went to class.
I was a total fool.
See?
I didn't change my life until the 10th grade.
See?
When I was cutting, I was like, they kicked me out of Cleveland.
Oh. You from Cleveland?
Yes.
I'm from Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah, I lived in Columbus, like on Livingston Road.
Oh, East Side, Livingston Road.
Let me tell you,
all the old dogs.
After I graduated college, you know, I moved to Columbus, and I hated it so bad because
your
driving,
ass was cold.
My stepmother is there right now.
But let me tell you, it was just driving. That
in
was
the
only.
Ice.
It was just
cold.
It was an accident every. Yay!
Exactly.
Yeah. And it only got four lanes.
Yeah, but you drive here every day.
Right, and it's an accident.
And I hate
every
it
every day.
And I hate
it. But these accidents
that
hold you. But this
second.
Accident here will hold your life up
it's
here.
Terrible.
Anybody got any shout outs that you want to give before? I'm gonna go ahead and start with our guest first. You know, Mr. Sting.
I got to give a shout out to my boy Barry Thomas and Douglas Roddy, Danny Tabor, African Collective, Diverse Entertainment. Putting it down all this time.
Yes, sir.
Keep doing it.
Exactly.
Keep doing it.
I'm going to give a shout out to every actor, actress out there that is putting the grind on every day. True, hey, guys, it's not too late. It's not over. Keep your head up.
Exactly.
We're going to get ours.
That's right. Clap for that.
Oh, I got to give it up for that one. And I got to give it up to Mr. Stank, too, as well. Ikor?
Yeah.
You know, I like to save the best for last, Mo, but go ahead, Ikor.
Yeah, I'd like to send a shout out to my brother, B-Rock. He out there listening right now. And then all of my people in Detroit, Joy Road, West Warren, Tyman, Fisk University.
Hey.
You know, Defy Pro Sport, Dorsey High School. We just had a pep rally over there today and spoke over there. And, you know, hopefully you guys won tonight. And big ups to all the students out there, you know, across the nation, man. Stay in school. Be right. Respect your parents. Obey your parents. And make something happen with yourself.
Do the right thing.
Do the right thing.
That's right.
Do the right, all these coordinations.
Hey, there's
tonight.
Nothing wrong with that.
Do the right thing. Do the right
whatever
thing.
Whatever the right thing is.
And shout to God Almighty.
In your mind.
It's all a matter of perspective.
Right. Oh, and shouts to God Almighty, you know? So.
Okay. Mo?
Shout out to the Shock Factor and LA Talk Live, Rich and Ness. Thank you so much for all the support.
Why are you laughing at me for?
Because you're retarded. I'm sorry, not retarded. That's not politically correct to say that. I
you
apologize.
Know that.
You'll
so
get letters. Right. You'll get letters for that. Yeah.
I apologize for that statement.
Oh, my God. Right.
Tweets.
Shaquem is slow. I'm just putting it like that.
He's special.
He's special. He's special. That's it. Extra
she
special.
She said that.
Shout out to TP for sliding through. Shout out to the Los Angeles Dolls. Our winter league is
what's going on with that?
Is
restarting?
On the way. I'm so excited. So to everybody that's responsible, LAHC, shout out to What's the Count and Power Tech and all the people that have supported us thus far. Follow me. I'm on Instagram. Since we're talking about social media, I am Chef Momo.
Chef Momo.
Check out my website, Francis Rose Catering. Shout out to my mom. Shout out to my artist, Emma Renna, and to you, Shot. Thanks for having me.
Wow, great. Thank
always.
You so much.
One big happy family.
I got a shout out to my sister-in-law, Sharon, Shea Boogie.
Okay, your shout outs are we're done there, buddy.
We're done with that, young man. Thank you very much.
We're done with your shout
out. I got a voice over here. So
thank you for participating.
You had your chance.
Right.
You had your time. Get it in when you can.
Right.
Now, once again, no, seriously, thank you, Ikor.
No doubt.
Ikor the Woof.
Ow.
In the building. I want to give it up to Mr. Thomas, Mr. Stain, for coming in. Your wealth of information.
Love it.
Love. And hey, once I gotta give y'all, you know, applause. I wanna let you know, guys, know y'all welcome to come back anytime y'all got something to say and share with us. And I'm gonna be asking you anyway. So just, you know, if you can stay in contact because you got so
absolutely.
Much information. I want to give mad love to our Atlanta clique that's listening in to right now. Atlanta, Georgia, in the house.
In the building.
LA, everybody that's out here tuned in. We want to thank you guys for tuning in. To our people that's in London that's tuned in, that's, you know, sent me a couple of tweets. I want to thank you guys for tuning in as well. It's kind of late. Well, it's actually early over there. Well, it's kind of late over there right now. So I want to give shouts out to Cleveland. You know, the Browns play Cincinnati this week.
Don't hate. Hold up now. Hold up.
Shout out
respect the state system.
Shout out to Cedar Point.
Don't go there.
I mean, I know you're killing people and all.
I'm just saying, respect the state.
He got the look.
Come on,
he got the
look.
Give it a look.
I'm going to get you.
But no, I want to thank
everybody. Cleveland Brown sucks. I'm put it out.
She is from Philly.
Damn
and,
right.
Really? You should be quiet.
Yeah.
Now would be a good time to be silent.
I mean, compared to the Cleveland Browns.
Did you see the game?
I did see the game.
Did you see the game? Last
it's
Sunday?
One game.
Nah.
Oh.
I see didn't watching no game.
She ain't watching no game.
She just repping.
She just talking.
Yeah, she just repping.
You know what? I like players. I don't like teams. But the Browns suck. Like, I'm stand by what I'm saying.
Man, I
know the killer's up.
Hey, wait a minute. We got to cut that out because that was crazy talk. We ain't having no crazy talk up in here when we get ready to leave. I'm going to give you one more chance. One more. You say that again. You hurt my feelings. I'm going to jump over this table and get you, Keita.
Don't test me.
Okay. So anyway, want to thank Mo. Really, you are always a delight and such an inspiration to us.
Thank you, sir.
Every time you come here with your beautiful smile.
Yeah.
Thank you for lightening up LA Talk Live and the Shock Factor.
I do try.
Well, you don't have to try. You do.
You do.
So you said the first time, you do. Don't put try. That's like almost a double.
Man, you better
that's like
that.
An oxymoron. And, you know,
right,
in a
he's
sense.
Doing that.
Professor,
he's
you know.
Classes out.
Professor Wong.
Like, look, get your classes out.
Want to thank Ecor the Wolf for. Once again, showing love and coming up to the station.
Don't forget the beautiful film crew.
We gotta get them.
You know, thank you for you know. I wasn't
gonna shout them out.
I'm always shouting.
Great
Renee.
Job, guys.
This is my crew right here. We love you.
Joey
and you know, we're gonna be doing major things together. We're gonna take them around the world with us.
Yeah, I got some stuff for y'all.
Can I just say one quick thing?
Yeah.
That's a perfect example. You see what they got in their hands? That looked like a regular old 35 millimeter camera. Yes. Now, that's a movie camera.
That's some real boy.
That's some crazy stuff. That's crazy.
Right.
No
right.
film. Yeah. No, just a camera with a dip. You know, it's crazy.
And
it's crazy. It's a movie.
Out here shooting movies with those.
It's crazy.
Yeah. And new technology, you know.
That's what made me speak earlier. I said with all the new technology and all that stuff, you know, being y'all being, you know, actors from way back, was, you know, when he asked that question, you know.
So
that's
it's,
where we at now.
It's a crazy
saturated.
Day.
I didn't know that.
Oh, really?
Well, I wasn't really focusing in on it.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Those cameras, yeah. My cameraman has this, you know, the camera.
He's taking snapshots.
Oh. No. Shoot movies with them things.
All right. So, nevertheless, guys, we want to go ahead and thank you for that brief pause of camera.
Camera talk. Sponsored by Camera Talk.
Reality.
On LA Talk Live.
Reality Radio. Handcrafted. Y'all
just
listening.
Live.
You know, I do have the longest wrap up ever of all time.
Gosh.
And it's only because people be stopping me when I want to talk and see.
We don't want to leave, Shaq, because, you know, this show's so hot off the hook.
We just not really got started.
Please
you know,
don't
it's
stop
them. It's just warming up.
Yeah, we know we got LAX After Dark with Shamrock and Igor.
Hey, so, look.
We're talking to Shamrock and Igor.
There's nothing wrong with LAX After Dark. It's off the chain. Where the women at? Show you. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen.
Ain't no women coming up here. Ain't nobody coming up here.
Okay.
They might be in the room back there.
they not.
In and out, next door.
That's the right. We're going to the hamburger place.
Melly's
bar. They got some midgets.
Uh-oh, you gotta be careful.
You gotta
be careful again.
Ain't
little,
no mention.
Okay,
you gotta
the
be careful,
people,
they call little people.
They have little people under the desk.
You needed to be careful, Mo.
You gotta be careful.
Mo, you 5'2"?
Okay. I'm 5'4" and a half.
Ooh, big girl. Big fat bag foul
and a half.
I'm sorry, little people. I did not mean to. I messed it up.
It's okay. We're gonna just take his parts, you know, y'all parts. We're gonna cut everything else out.
Yeah, right.
Put that on the right. thing and just show that one. Can't have the little. Yeah. Nobody offended, you know.
Nobody offended.
We have a lot of little people out there watching us, Mo. You need
to
be careful.
Yes, I apologize. I from the bottom of my heart, I'm sorry.
We love you all.
This is Momo's statement. It wasn't LA Talk Live or the Shock Factor.
Disclaimer.
Yeah,
disclaimer.
That in there too, right?
Disclaimer.
That in there too.
We love you for that, Mo.
Oh, God, the longest wrap-up ever. This is the longest ever
no,
this
it's
year.
Not.
48,000 bars.
I got at least 5 or better. So, look.
I'm about to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to The Shock Factor. Here on LA Talk Live, every Friday, once again, we do this every Friday, 8 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. We want you guys to tune in next week. We got a great show lined up for you as well. But this show, once it was great. And I'm a little choked up.
And we know that you have a choice in radio, internet radio to listen to, but we also are thankful and appreciative that you tuned into LATalkLive.com.
Somebody give this man an asthma.
Look at that man, a snigger, man. He over there like Patty LaBelle. He over there like
acting class.
I'm acting, so maybe I could be his assistant.
You are terrible. He acting.
And scene. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in once again to The Shock Factor. We love you for tuning in at the same time.
Yeah.
Same time, same place, all the time. We're here at 8 o'clock once again on LA Talk Live, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasures.
Yes, sir.
I'm your host, Shaquem Williams.
I'm Omo.
Ecor the Wolf.
And we are out of here. I want to thank my friends, my family. I'm not done wrapping up.
I want to thank my friends, my family, everybody that's tuned in. The music is getting louder. I can't hear nothing. There's no singing up in here.
You see it in my room. I see it in your list over now.
See you next week, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in. We love you, man.
One love.
Oh, it's my cloud. We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.